Recently, I was speaking with a group of CEOs, around 30 of them, from all over the country. And we were talking about different ways people can engage in disrespectful behaviors, whether it be leaders, whether it be management, whether it be employees at any level of an organization. And one topic came up that we are now seeing starting to trend in the United States that it's important we discuss. Here is what was going on. There are leaders in organizations who are saying they will go to dinners one-on-one with a man after work hours to brainstorm, to talk work, business, whatever they want to discuss, but they will not go to that same style of dinner with a woman. Now, let's stop and think about that for a second. That is blatant discrimination. You are saying, I'm going to deny access to an entire gender. Right, that's literally the definition of discrimination. You're not choosing to deny access to a person because of their behavior, to an entire gender. You are denying access to them that you would give to other genders. Literally discriminating against. And there's only one of two reasons somebody would do this. One, you think that you yourself, as a leader, are so dangerous that if left alone with a woman, you don't know what you'll do. And therefore, you have to protect yourself from yourself, so you don't let yourself go to dinner with women. Now, if that is the case, you need to get help, because that is a serious problem if you cannot be left alone with a woman without fearing what you're going to do and you lead an organization. Now, you might be sitting there going, Mike, that is not my situation. Well, then it's reason number two that we hear from leaders, which is, well, I'm just protecting myself. Now, what they're referring to there is that going to dinner with a man is safe. You know, men are safe, trustworthy. They don't lie, they don't manipulate. They're not gonna put me in a dangerous situation. But women I cannot feel safe with because they do lie, they will make stuff up, and there's a chance that I'll be falsely accused of something. And this is the only other reason there could be for doing this, right? Or some will say, well, my wife doesn't trust me alone with women. Whoa, then you're the problem again. Not women, so stop denying women access, right? Or your partner is a problem. If they don't think they can trust you, that speaks volumes of your relationship, right? And not on the people that you actually employ. By the way, you hired these people. So if they're not trustworthy, why do you hire them? The fact is that if you're going to be an equal opportunity employer, you need to equally provide opportunity. And those dinners where in-depth conversations are taking place about business is opportunity. Opportunity for that person to grow, to learn more about you, to learn more about what you want for the business so they can create that, and you're denying that out of made-up fears that somebody's gonna falsely accuse you of something. And somebody going, Mike, what do you mean it's made-up fears? How many CEOs do you think you know, or organizations that are in your inner circle that have ever been falsely accused? There's this myth out there that false accusations are happening all over the place, when the reality is they're incredibly, incredibly rare. Rare. And so you're gonna deny access to an entire gender based on a tiny, tiny percentage of rare behavior that ever happens by one gender. Oh yeah, you seem to be forgetting that who's saying that a man won't falsely accuse you of something? Accuse you of saying something you didn't do or behave in a way you didn't behave in that moment. Look, if you're going to be a great leader, then you need to show respect for all people in your organization. That means you need to give equal opportunity to all people. And by the way, when you do that, you bring more creativity, more problem solving, people feel more valued. It ironically impacts what maybe some people only care about, the bottom line. It impacts it dramatically because you draw people who want to be part of an organization where everybody cares for each other, values each other, trusts each other, and treats each other with respect. That's what we're all about here at the Center for Respect, is helping organizations build that culture. Look, we tend to work with the CEOs who do believe that every human being deserves to be treated with respect. Every human being. And they want to help bring that to their entire culture, their entire management team, employees at all levels. They want to bring that to them. And we know that most CEOs do want to do the right thing. So let's start doing the right thing by stop denying access to individuals purely based on identity. Come on, by common sense, we can all know that's wrong. Let's do the right thing. Let's include everyone consistently. This is Mike Domitsch with the Center for Respect.